Josh?
Josh!
How does it feel? Do you enjoy all those emotions that my sisters got to feel once, 1 year ago? Only guess what? They didn't get to laugh it off. No! Nope! No, no, no! They're gone!
Jessica's fucking dead!
What?
Did you hear me? Jessica is dead. And you are gonna fucking pay, you dick!
What happened with Jess, Mike? I don't remember killing Jess.
Christ.
Oh, God! Oh, my God, Matt!
He was gonna help us.
What? Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh boy. Oh, shit.
Yeah. That's a flare.
Oh my God.
Hello, hello, my name's James King Joker, and welcome to Until Dawn. I said he was going to help us, I said it, I did. Right, now, what we're just going to quickly do is check in here, because there was other stuff. Right, has this all come back to what it was? Okay, well, let me just get rid of these update forms. Or notices. Don't really know what to say. Right. Then we did get a totem, but we didn't ever check it.
Thing. Am I? Sometime after the prospectors. Until a cave-in trap. And driven mad. Murderers. Cannibals eating. A year ago, I was finally able to get him in my sights. But we were not alone in the woods that night. I couldn't save you.
Ah. There we go. Oh, there's still updates. Okay. What was that? Depth Chris. Josh felt betrayed and antagonized Chris. Chris considered violence. Is that it? Yeah, that's it. Right, let's go. Let's try not to die. So I'm guessing that the creature doesn't like, either doesn't like light, or it's just scared of fire. And actually, I just want to quickly check on some things here. Right. I've gone way past it already. I just wanted to have a look at the totems. Blah, blah, blah. Alright. So. Nope. This one. That's, seriously, who is that? Is that Jess? I don't know. Right, anyway. Just wanted to see if there's a way I could die that I've already seen. Okay. What is this? Oh, no!
Okay, this is gonna be the way.
Okay, we're going this way.
Oh, God!
Shit!
What the? Oh, my! Come on! Come on, Emily! Emily! Oh, no! Oh, what the hell is that? It's horrifying! And it's just... Oh! Go right! Right is the right! Is Gollum trying to kill us?
You have a flare. You have a flare. This isn't going to end well, is it? Okay, I did it. We're outside. Come on, Emily. Come on, Emily. Come on, Emily. Right, Emily. Run on it. Run on it. Run on it. Are you alive? Oh no, this isn't gonna end well. She's alive? Oh! Okay. Woo! I was not able to shoot it. I didn't get it in time. Are you? Oh, okay. Still Emily. Yes, the cabin!
Let me in!
Let her in quick!
Let Emily in!
Shut the door! Oh my God, shut the door!
Are you all right?
I didn't think that I'd make it.
You were screaming bloody murder.
Are you okay?
You look totally lost.
There was something.
Where's Matt? Come sit down, sit down.
Something's out
there. Did you guys split up?
A monster and some...
Wait. What are you talking about?
I said there's something out
like
there.
Like what? Ash, relax, it was Josh. It was all Josh.
No, listen to
we
me.
We got him tied up. He can't hurt you.
No, it was after me and it wasn't human.
Hold on. Wait, Em, where's Matt? Is he okay?
Matt, oh God, we couldn't use the cable car, so we climbed the tower, and then it fell, and we were down in the mine, like, way down, down in this terrifying freaking mine shaft.
Hold on.
And then it was Matt and me down there, and... Oh God, I think that Matt might be dead.
Wait, what?
Ow!
Emily, what happened?
I was walking down there in the mines, and it was dark, and I found this pile, and... There was Beth's head.
Wait, what?
Beth's head, I found
it. Oh my God.
What the fuck?
Are you serious?
Yes, I'm serious.
I think they fell down there.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
But the worst part is I don't think that Hannah died, like, from the fall, not right away.
Wait, what do you mean?
I don't know, I feel like she was down there, like, starving to death for weeks, when we were all up here looking for her, and we had no idea.
That's horrible.
Listen, in the tower, there was a radio, and I got through to someone, but then that was right when the tower collapsed.
Em, you made it.
Oh, God,
yeah,
Mike.
What about Matt?
We're trying to figure that out.
Yeah, and there was this monster that was chasing her.
She's all messed up, guys. Emily? Hey, Em?
Whoa.
Who the fuck can that be?
Don't open the door.
Jess?
Don't.
It's not Jess.
Sorry, man, but who is it?
I don't know. We should check it out.
I got your back. Good.
If it's the man, if it's Bernie Sanders, okay, I'm willing to let him in. It looks like Bernie Sanders. Let my captain go.
I'm gonna open the door. You ready? You ready? Just do it already. Whoever it is probably calling me now. Unless you want me to take the gun.
No. I think that's less good. You do the door. I got the gun.
Nah, that looks like Bernie Sanders.
Hold on there, mister.
Close the door.
Ah, what? All right. Just take it easy, Grandpa.
Okay, everybody, just calm down. Now, just move over there. Go on, move. Let me say what I came to say. I'm here to tell you what you're up against being back on this mountain. You should never have returned. I don't know why you did after what happened last year.
You mean with Hannah and Beth?
Yeah, how could you know without being involved?
Or responsible.
You hold on to your
horses. It was in the news, wasn't it?
I don't take kindly to you kids coming up here to my mountain.
Your mountain? I'm sure the Washingtons would be very surprised to hear that.
Well, the mountain don't belong to me, it's true. But it don't belong to the Washingtons. This mountain belongs to the Wendigo.
Woo!
What's he talking about?
Told ya!
The hell's a Wendigo?
Let's hear him out.
Told ya!
Like we have a choice.
Now, I'm only gonna tell you this once.
Doesn't have horns, but you know.
Doesn't matter to me if you believe it or not. I got reasons I want to get it off my chest.
See? I told you. He's guilty as shit. Guilty as something.
Shut up, Mike.
There is a curse that dwells in these mountains. Should any man or woman resort to cannibalism in these woods,
there we go.
The spirit of the Wendigo shall be unleashed.
Yeah.
Oh, crap.
Somewhere safe.
The basement might be okay.
Okay, get down there now, all of you, and wait.
What? Why? For how long?
Until dawn.
Guys, I ran off and left Josh when I heard screaming.
Where did you leave him?
In the shed.
Your friend will already be dead.
No, he can't be. We were just with him.
A lot can happen quickly on this mountain.
No. I'm gonna go get him.
You can't go out there, Chris.
I'm supposed to be his best friend, and I let him down.
No, he let you down, Chris. He let all of...
And I'll go with you.
Okay, good.
I don't need your help.
You're going
yes, you do.
Suicide.
Fine.
The rest of you, get down to the basement. Be safe. Don't go outside again until we're back. You don't seem to understand the magnitude of the situation.
Well, I'm going to get Josh, aren't I?
No, I'm going to get Josh. You're going to help me. Do you understand?
Yeah, I think so.
You need to follow me and do everything I tell you.
Do I get it? Yes.
Point towards the thing you want to kill.
I know how to use a shotgun, man.
No, you don't.
What? How do you know?
Trust me, I know.
Hey, come back safe.
Ooh!
We need to hurry, son.
Hell yeah. Matt? I mean,
so
Chris?
So tell me, you're the expert
Matt's
on
dead.
These things. What's the guy gotta know?
You just be careful. You follow my lead.
Ah, hell yeah. Whoop, whoop. Alright, who gets the gun? Emily kept the flare gun. Matt had no offense against attack. Emily had a defense against the attack. Okay. So, maybe either one of them. But then, I sort of failed with the flare gun and I survived anyway, so... could have still saved both of them. Damn it. Ashley was concerned about Chris as he left. Once bit, Emily was bitten. Yeah. I have a feeling that the Wendigo might work as some sort of zombie. Right? So it's like, it's bitten her. And just by this, once bitten, she might turn. She might turn cannibalistic. I do not know. But we've only got three of these things left. What's this one? Right, supported Emily's plan to go to the tower to get help. Okay. Right, let's go. Let's go, Chris.
So, how many times do I have to shoot it with the shotgun before it's dead?
Well, you'd be shooting it a long time.
You mean this thing won't even kill it?
No, it'll slow it down.
Well, how do you kill it?
They don't like fire.
I don't like fire.
They fear it. And it can kill them, if you have to. See, their skin is like... it's like tough armor. Unless you burn it off first. It's gross.
I have a feeling...
what are these things like? I mean, are they just crazy unpredictable, or... I mean, can you figure out what
Hannah
is
the one to go.
Well, they adhere to some pattern.
Like how? Like they've got schedules?
Well, they only hunt at night.
Oh. Why?
I didn't ask.
Which is spooky spook, isn't it?
The pro Wendigo tips? Like if I rub garlic all over me, they won't be able to smell me or something?
They'll still smell you.
Yeah,
anything like that?
I can't see you if you're standing still.
Ah!
Sight is based on changes of movement in their field of vision.
So if I don't move, I'm basically invisible.
Yeah. Well, I wouldn't recommend testing it out. Unless you have no other choice.
Well, we know it works. Because that's what Emily did. So let's go hunt Wendigos.
Wendigos are or were human. They still have some aspect of humanity in them?
Well, they retain certain things.
I mean, is it really right to kill them? Maybe they could be cured or...
they surrender human rights the moment they eat one another. There's no cure, there's no redemption.
I mean, if they're still human, I don't know if it's right to hurt them.
Yes.
When you're staring one in the face, it's them or you. You feel free to take the high road. You won't be on it for long.
Oh.
Am I allowed in here? Nope.
Damn it.
All right.
Josh, he could still be out there.
First, the Wendigo. He'll render you immobile. And then he strips the skin off of your entire body, piece by piece. keeps you alive and aware and feasts on your organs, one piece at a time.
So the launch then.
Yeah.
Let's go now.
Right, Bernie Sanders.
You might still be near.
Come on, help me. Something bad's about to happen. Something bad's about to happen. Something bad's about to happen.
Wait. Don't move. Be very quiet.
Oh no!
Run!
I move!
Gotta get out of here.
Oh my god. Shit. Oh good. Red Chris. Come on, Chris. Come on, Chris. Come on, Chris. Come on, Chris. Come on. Battle Lodge. Battle Lodge. Bernie Sanders is dead. No! Oh, no. Chris. Chris, go. You're gonna die again!
Ash! Oh, thank God, please, let me in quick!
Oh, my God. Oh, I've seen that footage.
Oh, my God, what happened?
Yeah, we gotta go. That thing was, like, right behind me. Go, 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 go!
Oh, man. Oh, he's got Josh!
Not so good up there right now.
Understatement of the night.
Chris, where's the flamethrower guy?
He didn't make it?
No.
What happened?
The thing, it tore him apart.
Off
right in front of me.
Oh, God.
All right. These all the doors?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
What are you looking for?
Another way out.
Mike, look, I really don't think that's a good idea. We should stay put right here until dawn. At least we're safe down here.
Oh, yeah? All wrapped up like a little present with a bow on top for that thing to tear us apart on Christmas morning?
People will come for us in the morning.
You don't sound so sure.
That is what'll happen, right, Em?
Yeah,
yes.
I mean, right?
Well, you can wait. I'm leaving.
Mike, there's no key for the cable car.
Josh, he's gotta have it.
Josh?
One of his dirty little tricks.
Great.
Great.
That fucking thing got a hold of Josh, then we're shit out of luck.
I don't know, Mike. It's possible.
What's possible?
It may have taken him down to the mine.
What?
I saw some horrible stuff down there. I think it's where that thing lives, and... Huh.
Em, what?
Fuck it. I'm gonna get that key right from that thing's goddamn bedroom, and then I'm gonna get us all the hell out of here.
And what is all that?
It's, that old guy's bag.
Is that a map?
That guy was prepared for anything.
Not quite.
What is this place?
Oh, my God.
Wait, what is that?
I was down there. It was horrible.
You were?
There'd been a cave-in in the 50s, I guess, and these miners got trapped down there.
Oh, my God.
Some of them survived, but, like, 15 of them didn't make it. There was this reporter, and I think he figured out there had been some, like, big cover-up going on. I found these plans. They knew the mine was a death trap, but they let the miners keep working anyway. And I'm not sure what it means, but I found this chair. Dried blood all over the place, like somebody'd been tortured.
Michael, I'd like to maybe focus on how we're gonna get the fuck out of here, please.
I'm just saying, it's weird how much crazy shit's gone on up here.
Yeah.
What's weird is that there's a tunnel leading from the lodge to the sanatorium, see?
That's how I got back here.
I saw this when I was down there. That's where it lives.
What is that?
Huh?
What is that?
Ash.
What's what?
Oh my god, oh my god,
it's,
oh my god.
It's nothing,
god.
It just,
oh no,
it bit
no.
me and...
Bit you? What bit you?
The Wendigo.
What?
It's nothing, really, it's not a big deal.
You okay?
Shit.
It doesn't hurt anymore, really, it's not that bad.
Em, if that thing bit you...
I know what you're thinking, and I'm fine.
Are you?
Yes!
Emily, at least let us check it out.
Emily, if the Wendigo bit you, you could turn into one of those things.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
He said it was from eating each other. Remember, he said that.
Is that how it worked?
Yes, it happens. If it bit you, you're gonna turn into one, and then you're gonna turn on us. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god!
You can't be down here with us.
What?
Mike!
You what?
Gotta go.
Are you kidding me?
You're putting us all in danger.
Like hell I am!
Emily! You can't stay here.
Mike, just cool your head, okay? We don't know if it works like that. Maybe it's just a bite.
I've seen what these fuckers can do. And I don't want to say it again.
What is this? Guys, what are you doing?
Door's right here. I am letting you do this voluntarily.
Oh, no. You're just making yourself feel better about sending me to my death since you know there's a Wendigo out there ready to rip me to pieces like it did with... Okay, oh my god, will you just go? Go, get out of here!
Whoa, okay. Whoa, Mike, calm down.
You're gonna shoot me? Mike, me?
This is the safe room, Em.
Please.
It is not safe as long as you're in it. Not for us.
Don't do this!
I'm really sorry.
No. No, I'm not doing it.
Fuck, I can't do this.
Oh my god. You did the right thing.
I hope you did.
Maybe. For now.
There's that room you were locked in.
Fuck. Keep an eye on her. If you see anything weird, you guys know what to do.
Yeah.
No one leave. Okay? It's not safe out there. I'll be back soon.
Mike, should you really go alone? Like, really? Ash?
I thought that he was gonna help us.
With the flamethrower, dude?
No, we don't have a chance.
No, guys, it just means we've got to be tough. We've got to do this on our own.
I don't know if I can.
Only a few men have dared to hunt the Wendigo.
This guy's a little OCD.
Okay, I didn't even get to swipe that. You know what? I'm just going to do it like this. Only a few men have dared to hunt the Wendigo. I am the only man who has ever kept them under control. Heed these words, or it shall be your death. And your death will not be the last. The Wendigo must be contained. The Wendigo grows out of cannibalism. When a human is desperate and craves food, trapped on the mountain in the fierce winter storms, when he has eaten nothing for many days, the Wendigo spirit will begin to possess him. Even the strongest man is weak to it. He will kill without remorse, often those companions who have travelled with them. He will eat the flesh raw from the corpses. I have seen this happen many years ago. A craving of flesh that cannot be satiated. Sated. I don't know the word. I don't know the word. And then the change begins. The eyes turned first and they became milky and white. Then the teeth became longer, like fangs. The creature growls and the skin is pulled taut across the bones. Oh, okay. Right, so what? So when it comes to Emily, just gotta make sure her eyes don't go white. Make sure her teeth stays the same. And the creature growls. And the skin is... Okay, yep, so then the skin... Blah, 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 blah. And then we got this one. Local man found dead. Lies. Lies. This journal is an account of the Wendigo. This creature is real and dangerous. If you are reading this, you will have questions. But I do not have all the answers. This is all evidence and stories of my own experience. Okay. Alright. There was a tribe that lived in these mountains, the Cree. Their shamans tell stories of a tall creature born in ice. The tribe respected the mountain and all the animals which lived on it. The mountain became scarce to the Cree, sacred to the Cree. Every animal became sacred also. The Cree believed it was bad luck to harm an animal on the mountain and would hunt elsewhere. Oh. Oh no. Oh, that... Wow. Okay. Yeah. That means Emily is probably... No, not Emily. Jess is probably dead then. Because she threw a bird at a... No, she threw a... She killed a bird. In 1893, the miners arrived. They found tin and later traces of radium. The mine... Deep into the sacred mountain, the Cree say that the mountain cried out and the spirit was released. Clue found. Oh, okay, so this is introduction, cannibalism, so that's how it can turn. History, and then we got combat. Right, so this is a good one to use. Oh, Mike shouldn't have run off yet. The Wendigo's eyes change. They become both sharper and more dim. The Wendigo sees movement. It is a hunter like a hawk, but it can not be silenced. If you are to keep totally still, then the Wendigo will not be able to see you. The skin and flesh of the Wendigo are hard, like armor. They seem to feel no pain. They cannot be cut or stabbed. Bullets will not pierce their skin, though a shotgun will keep them at bay. Because the Wendigo is mutated from a human, it knows how to hunt us. It can perfectly mimic its prey. You must remain sharp and disciplined. Oh. So what? It can make it seem... Oh. So say, like, if Emily was down there, you could go, Emily, this is Matt's voice, Emily. And it's like, uh-oh, oh no. I've killed 6 Wendigos. Oh, nice. Knives or bullets will not harm them. Use a flamethrower. It is the best weapon. Fire. Sorry, I thought I heard something. Envelopes. Envelopes them. Burns away their skin and makes them weak, but try not to kill them. Killing the Wendigo should be the last resort. Death releases the Wendigo's spirit into the air. Oh. I have contained them. I use traps to catch them and fire to drive them into cages. The traps were baited with human limbs from those who I had no further use for them. Okay. Once by one, I caught those who had infested the mountain. Oh, okay. A bite. Okay, this is what we need to know. This is what we need to know. There may be defenses, shamans wrote of rituals. I have found native artifacts in the mountain and copied them. Totems. Oh, okay. So they come in, make him relevant now. Bunches of herbs and feathers. I copied their designs. I have tested them out of the mountain. They work. They keep the Wendigo at bay. Not entirely, but enough. But inside buildings, they do not work. Cree legends say that the Wendigo grows from the bite of another Wendigo, but the bite is harmless. I have been bitten, but I did not change. The only way is to eat the flesh of another. There is no other way. Okay, so Emily's fine then. Oh, good, I didn't shoot her. That's amazing. If you shot her and then you read this, you're like, oh no. Ways to eat the flesh of another. Okay, so yeah, so the bite, basically, yeah, so the bite's nothing. Grows. Legends say Wendigo grows from the bite of another Wendigo, but the bite is harmless. I have been bitten, but I did not change. The only way is to change from eating other flesh. Okay. Okay then.
Oh no.
What?
No.
What is it? What does it say?
It says that the bites, if it bites you, it's not infectious. It doesn't do anything.
Let me see that.
I'm sorry, what did you say? It says you'll be okay.
It says what? You're gonna be fine.
Fine? Michael almost shot me, is that
he
fine?
He didn't shoot you.
And this bitch almost let him.
Hey, that's not fair, she was scared.
I'm the one who's scared.
I'm sorry, Emily. I didn't know what was going to happen.
None of us know. There's no excuse,
Emily.
Like,
please, just try to understand.
Understand the palm of my hand, bitch.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Shit. We've got to get to Mike. Like, now.
Joshua, you should have listened to me. Because of your choices, people have died. I don't know which is worse, actively triggering events that lead to someone's death, or passively allowing a tragedy to occur. Because you couldn't lift a goddamn finger to help someone else. Remember last year, huh? You left your poor sisters to die. You did nothing to help. Paralyzed by your own self-centered fear. While a real threat was closing in. Now it's all about you, Josh. It's always all about you. Your game has gone terribly wrong. And your friends, like your sisters, have deserted you. You're all alone. Can you feel how cold your loneliness has become? Huh? Why did you hurt them? Joshua, why did you hurt them? Well, they didn't hurt you, Joshua. Not intentionally. They made a stupid mistake, and a terrible tragedy befell your sisters. I did not intend for that to happen. It just did. And they were sorry, at least, until you subjected them to your night of horrific torture. Let's hope that it's not too late for atonement. And that your friends, if they still are your friends, can save you from. It's terrible. Isolation.
Okay. That's interesting. It's in his head now, clearly. But this is the end of this episode, so thank you for watching after I check all this, though. Where is it? Update. Update. This must have been Wendigo sightings of the mystery guy was collecting. Ah, okay. Who gets the gun? What happened here? Mike faced a dilemma. Ashley opened the door, saving Chris's life. Oh. So if I... So if I chose to shoot her instead, she wouldn't open the door? Ashley opened the door, saving Chris's life. Oh, okay. Mike spared Emily. Ashley was faced with a dilemma and told the truth. In that situation, the truth is definitely better to tell, because then you're not gonna, everyone's just gonna still be suspicious of her. Anyway, my name is James Kinchoka. This has been Until Dawn, and you'll see me in the next episode, because I won't see you. Unless you want a building dropped on you.